Hi, my name is Shashin Greenaway, and in this demo, we're going to be working through some error handling. In this demo, we're working with two functions. This first one is critical code that throws an exception for us that we'll see throughout the demo. And then we are also using another one that we'll see called log error, and that will just print the exception to the console. In this first example, we are throwing two exceptions. The first one is a string, and the next one is Boolean. And notice that my syntax highlighter actually faded out line 13, because remember that exceptions and thrown exceptions are an interruption in your code. So that essentially means that code that might show up after an exception is thrown might not get run. And that's what my syntax highlighter is trying to tell me, and that's what my editor is trying to warn me about. When it's printed to the console, you can see that the exception that was thrown shows up, and then also the message that that exception carries, which is just my string. Now, if I were to throw that true example here, the one where I threw a Boolean on line 13, the one that is unreachable, it would just say throw true, and it would say true at the end here. Let's look at trycatch. So here we're calling the function critical code. And remember, that was the function we saw earlier that is throw an exception. So that means that code inside of the catch block here will definitely run. So here we write something to the console that says got an error, which you see here, and then we log the error, and we're just logging the exception that is in the critical code. So let's just scroll up here just to see what that looks like. So here, critical code, the exception was throwing an exception, so log error logs the exception. That's why it says throw an exception down here. So let's move along to throwing in trycatch. So this is very similar to what we did with that critical code function, except we're just throwing the exception right here into try. Normally you wouldn't want to throw an exception just like this. This would probably be in something like a if statement. For example, if you try to do something like a GET request and maybe you didn't receive the data that you were expecting, you might want to throw an exception. So in this example, we're throwing this exception. And again, we're writing to the console that we got an error, and then we log that error to the console. And so it says an exception that's thrown every time. So in this try catch final example, we again use that critical code function that we know will throw an exception. So that means that code inside this catch block will run. So it'll log this message that says got an error, and it'll also log the exception that's inside critical code. And then we move on to finally. The code inside the finally block will be run every time, no matter what. So even if critical code did not throw an exception, the code inside finally will run. And that's why it prints code that will always run here.